Welcome to Reptile Ridge. By far, the most popular of the Ridge's reptiles are the green Anoles. Anoles carolinensis is the species' scientific name. There are many different species of Anoles. Here in the Deep South, in the United States, the green Anole is the most common. If you go a little further down south, in the coastal regions and into Florida, the brown Anole species can also be found. Now remember, green Anoles and brown Anoles are two separate species. Right now, a big shout out to my friend Donna, Lizard Lady in Florida. I want the rest of you to check out her channel for some great pictures and footage of brown Anoles, so you can see the differences in the two. As I walk down the length of my prospective flower bed, I can see the fence lizards are also still active during the fall. This little fency has been in the same location for some time. He's claiming this old landscape timber as home base. How long will it hold up for him? I guess we'll have to see. All species of Anoles and most other reptiles are very territorial. The location of their territory can make or break them. Over on the north side of our 1 acre yard, along the edge of the woods, I found an adult male. I'm beginning to see more and more Anoles coming back out from a recent hibernation due to the colder weather. During the midday hours, as soon as the sun warms the temperatures into the 60s, the lizards come out to bask and hunt. Down on the south side, I've come across a large female. She's warming herself on a log. She sees something interesting. Probably me. Anoles do have excellent eyesight. Then, in a flash, she's off to search for food. The lizards have to take advantage of the warmer weather. They need to eat as much as they can. Sure, it's sunny and warm for now, but that's all about to change. Close to the house, I found my old friend Max, the male Anole that lives around the satellite dish. If you'll recall, this was also a popular location for the Anoles to hang out when we lived in town, back in Anole Alley. And like the old days in the alley, the Anoles aren't the only ones who live back here. We moved up here in the Red Hills last fall. It was a big change for the animals that already lived here, as well as for our family. But it didn't take long for everyone to adjust. Now, we have lots more room for our pets. And the wildlife up here is simply amazing. For us, this is the perfect location. As for all those boxes of stuff left over from the move, well, the Anoles knew exactly what to do with them. Move in. Anoles are surprisingly intelligent little reptiles. They soon took over the junk piles. Even old discarded gardening equipment makes for an excellent Anole abode. I guess it's a really good thing for us that we don't have to deal with those strict neighborhood housing codes. Besides, this is all in the back, where no one but us can see it. This little group of Anoles lives right behind the dog kennels and the cat's outdoor area. They are smart enough to know which side of the fence is the safest location, away from their enemies. Pit bulls are smart too. As you can see, Vincent's learned how to open the door. So far, I've found one male and several smaller females in this territory. I'd make a bad Tiger Woods joke, but I'd better not. Anyway, the Anoles have set up housekeeping in locations where they can readily find food, water, and shelter, such as the kennels and the cat's area. For now, I'll leave them be, so the old planners and other junk will be put to good use. I'm a lazy gardener. The Anoles are getting more out of this stuff than I am. Happy gardening, ladies. We'll check back with you later. Meanwhile, the little Anole around front, named Jenny, continues to share our home. She's picked a great place to live. Soon, each of them will face freezing temperatures, severe storms, even snow has been forecast for our area. In order for them to stay alive, where they choose to ride it out will determine who makes it and who doesn't. The cold wind is blowing. Will there be frost on the pumpkins tonight? I don't know.